Hello, comic fans, here's Earl Grey. Some writers of comics can leave their mark in your brain with just a few comics, or in the case of Carlos Trillo, for me, it's just these two comics. Alva Mayor, drawn by Alberto Breccia's son, Henrique. Carlos Trillo did some stuff with his father, Alberto Breccia, as well, but I haven't these books yet in my collection. So this is just the only Breccia Trillo collaboration in my collection. I've shown you this in my old panelogy about Argentinian comic creators, and for the very most part, his name is familiar for me. It's because of The Big Hoax, drawn by Domingo Herman Rafinha, in this Jacques Tardieu-ish, pretty precise style. It's a fantastic conspiracy crime noir plot on the balance, on the perfect balance between the absurd and the hard-boiled. That's a wonderful comic, and for good reason it made it really high up in my best of crime comic lists 2 or 3 years ago. So no wonder. And Carlos Trillo worked together with Mandrafinho on some other books, and he worked together with Jordi Bernet and Eduardo Risso, and still a lot of stuff to discover for me from Carlos Trillo, and I will go that route for sure. But no wonder that I was intrigued when this trilogy here popped up for dirt cheap, and you can still get these three books here, who contain a contained story. this story here has a start and ending, and it's ended in these three volumes, European album-sized hardcover, and you can still get all three of them, I've looked that up, for less than 15 euros. So I think buy them now, thank me later. I still was a bit skeptical when I saw this cover here, which I still think that it doesn't do the content justice, and especially the beautiful art from Juan Bobillo, who drew and colored all the stuff here. And it hints a bit into esoteric fantasy side of comicdom, which I'm not too fond of, with this lady here and the firebird and stuff like that. But fortunately, this is not depicting the content, or this one here, this story here is more and hard-boiled, and again part-wise pretty absurd crime noir story. The sumo ringer here, a killer guy with his backpack with body parts. This is really pretty typical for the story, which borders sometimes really on hard-boiled Garth Ennis kind of stuff here. It's about this lady here who calls herself Bird after escaping the asylum, where her evil brother has put her in and drugged her he put some stuff into her bloodstream, her circulation, to get her out of circulation, because he wants to grab her inherited money from their grandmother. So that's just stuff you will come across on the very first some pages. So it's not really a spoiler, even though it's a bit hard to get into the story here, and you will appreciate later how beautifully it is done here. And she meets her supposed killer and tells him some story in a Scheherazade way of 2,000 stories of 1,001 night. So at least it has this this feel at first. Later on it's a bit different. But she's pretty calm, and yeah, you wonder what this strange tattoo is all about. That's all explained in the story here. And even her nudity has sense in a narrative kind of way. It's not to give us some TNA just for that purpose. Absolutely not. It's more to, and in my opinion, it's more to depict her fragility. She's a very fragile, broken character, even though there is a tough core inside her, else she would not be able to survive all the evil stuff that is thrown at her. And look at this beautifully done artwork by Juan Bobillo. He's an Argentinian as well. And I looked up his name to get a feeling what he has done since then or before. And he did a lot of stuff for Marvel. But hey, I would read Marvel a lot if the art would be as beautiful as this here. Wonderfully painted stuff. And again, when you flip through these books without reading the story, just the first time to get some feel for the story, you think maybe this it's a bit of about her having visions and or ghosts, and she really has visions, but that's just because of her drug abuse. And so it really makes sense in terms of the story. And the whole stuff could have been done by Alfred Hitchcock in a movie. Of course, the visuals would have been a lot different, but there's a psychological twist and the story of betrayal within the family and the tension and all that would have been intriguing for good old Hitch as well. Beautifully done stuff. I don't know what it is with these Argentinians, but you almost can't go wrong when you see some creator, writer or artist that comes from that place of the earth. You will get quality. That's my impression, at least. So, yeah. This is, I just can show you the beauty of this panel, these panels, and can hope that you really believe me that the story here is worth your money as well. So this is just volume one. This is volume two. And this cover here, it makes sense to depict her in this way here, because these are the both the double identity of the main character. And again, this is no spoiler as well, because you will really understand this particular fact very early. So, and yeah, but this cover is not so beautiful. I mean, I don't know. I like this. This guy here really is a funny guy. As far as funny killers can go. So, yeah, this is all that I wanted to show you today. Thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.